Star Citizen. You know, I have real trouble saying Star Citizen. I actually have difficulty saying the word citizen. Citizen. I don't know why. I just sort of... I don't know. It's funny, isn't it? Citizen. What is it about the word citizen that I find difficult? Star Citizen. I've actually never liked the name of the game. I'll be totally honest with you now, right? I've never liked the name Star Citizen as the name of a game. It seems like a name that's left over from other names that have been used up. Like, they've already thought of Space Engineers, they've already got, you know, EverQuest, they've already got Endless Space, they've already got EVE Online, they've got all these other names, Elite, you know, they've got all, and it was sort of like, you know, Chris and Erin sat one night and just ripped out pages of the dictionary with, oh, that's gone, they've taken that name. Well, that's that name. Oh, the EverQuest is gone, and they were left with like one page and it had the word Star and Citizen on it, and they went, well, we'll have to call it that. I'm afraid Star Citizen, do you like it? Not really. Well, it doesn't matter anyway, because we're going to make 160 million and then bugger off to Spain. No, I'm only kidding. That wasn't the intention at all. But it does feel like a strange name to me. I'd like to hear if there's anybody even out there listening to this drivel, if anybody's actually interested in commenting on what they think about the name of the game. Do they like the name Star Citizen? It's not easier to say Star Citizen. It's got like anyway. I digress. Let's hop in, see what we can see. I did have a plan, but I can't really remember what it was. Let's jump in here. There might be somebody I know in this server. Excitement. Somebody I know. Hello. I could owe you. Don't fly away from me. Hello. I've got a cutlass full of drugs if you want. Hello. Come back. See you later. Not if I see you first, mate. Anyway, I got into a little bit of bother earlier, so I've got a crime stat rating now, but I don't know if it seems to erase every time I come back on the game. It gets erased. I was really hoping. I want to wake up at Grim Hex. That's the whole point of it. Keep getting myself into all sort of scrapes and shenanigans and in the hope that I'll get a rating, and then I wake up clean as a whistle. It's like I've got a man on the inside who's covered up for me. Have you covered up this incident? Back in 2018 we discovered that you willfully rammed a retaliator into Olisar at very high speed repeatedly until it exploded. And it would seem that the record of this incident has been erased. Have you got somebody working in CIG who's helping you out?
No. I don't know what you're talking about. It wasn't me that rammed a retaliator repeatedly into Olisar. That's not happened.
And so you didn't receive a crime stat rating?
No, not at all, no.
Right, here we are. We're in. We've managed to get in now. So let's stop all this wittering nonsense. Absolute drivel. And just get on with the game.
What I actually want to do is try and have a look at this, because I need to reset that. My son. Yes, that's better, isn't it? That's much better. And we'll start again. Look at that. Very nice. Now, I'll tell you what I haven't got my camera on. There he is. Oh, lovely. Lovely fella. He's a lovely fella, that fella. Who is that blue geezer, anyway?
He's part of the Blue Man Group. He follows me around ever since I went to Berlin. He's been tailing me.
Right, where are we? We've woken up in a dump. Look at this. Like a squat. Magazines and noodles everywhere. There's a coat hanger, there's the rail, you know what to do. Here we go. We're in pod number 5!
Can never get it right! Never, ever, ever get it right. I'm never, ever going to finish this area. He's never, ever going to learn to read, no matter how hard he tries. Roll your trousers down. This isn't some kind of climbing centre. Right, somebody needs to polish all this up and make it shine like a newly born freelancer. Welcome. 16 frames, absolutely diabolical. Now, what we need to do is make some money. So what we'll do, we'll just jump in the old... Hey, that's a Grim Hex. That's a Grim Hex. That's a Grim Hex. Is there anything we can take? That's a Grim Hex. We could take the Buccaneer, but I've had no luck with it so far. I can't get in it, but we'll give it a go. I'm willing to.
Your ship has been delivered to the firing landing pad and incomplete.
Well, seems like I've completed my mission already. Right, AO7. Right then. Now then, you silly bunch of monkeys. I reckon we're going to go over here now and check this out. Because nothing, there's nothing like a trade to make you feel spayed. Right, come on then. Let's have a look at this. What can we do? We can't get anything. There's no ships. It means we can't look at anything. Can't look at any prices. This was a grave error on my part, ladies and germs. Never mind. Let's just get out of here. I can't remember what it was. A7, was it? AO7? Yes, must be. It's over there. Right, come on in. Let's get up these apples, up these pears. Through the door. Take a sharp right. Look at the Apex gang. Look at him. Fine member of the Apex gang. And the Apex gang, they don't wear t-shirts under their itchy jumpers. They just like the feel of the scratch. Just stay on their toes. Constant feeling of low quality wool rubbing against their collarbones. It's part of the test to be in. Are you in? If you're in the Apex game, you need to be able to take alpaca wool rubbing constantly against your epiglottis. Up we go, into the wild blue yonder. And there's the Drake Buccaneer. Now, I bet you any money, I bet you a million UAEC or whatever they're called this week. I can't get into this little thing. Look at this. I can already tell you. Look at it. Impregnable. Impregnable it is. Look at it. Oh, life is so ridiculous in the verse. Why do they call it the verse? Because it just can't get any worse. Right, let's try the other side just for jolly. I tell you what, I'm sick and tired of it. Sick and tired of them giving me this Buccaneer. I don't even know why I've got it. Alright. Right, I'll tell you now, that is the fourth time I've taken out that Buccaneer. And I can't get in it. I'll try this instead. What the hell? You know, I've got a clean record. I know it's going to be wiped. I'll get a piracy rating for this. It's going to be wiped anyway when I come back in the game. What the hell? Doesn't matter, does it? I've never flown one of these things anyway. Do you know why? Because nobody likes the tang of musk. Oi, that's my ship, mate. What are you doing? Where did he come from? He suddenly appeared out of nowhere. Look at him. Do you know what? This ship's never rendered properly. Look at that. It just doesn't work, does it? Nobody likes the tang of musk. Honestly. Right. I'm back inside then, aren't I? What the Buccaneer is all I can say to that. What the Buccaneer? What a way to start a stream. Every time I start the stream there's some impediment to my egress from this godforsaken sort of, it's like a Christian Bible camp, isn't it, Olisar? Full of right thinking individuals, citizens of the stars. It's like a vast neoliberal campaign for brainwashing. Right, I'm determined to do wrong, and you can't stop me. And no, I won't think about the consequences, because the consequences are going to be wiped by the time I'm 24 hours down the line. I won't care, will I? Grim Hex. You see the kind of guy I am? What's this tell you? Didn't want to wake up in the, you know, in the Bible Bashers Union? No! I'll wake up at Grim Hex where everything's edgy and slightly grimy around the edges. Right, okay.
And your ship has been delivered to the firing landing pad.
Well, just deliver it to me then. AO8. Now, I'm not a big fan of these ships, but, you know, everybody loves them, so I guess you've got to go along with it, haven't you? I'm like, meh. The Super Hornet. The Super Hornet.
a lovely ship.
Why do you think it's so nice?
Well, Chris said it was really nice. Super Hornet. It's got the word super in it.
Sorry, I don't mean to be disrespectful to Super Hornet owners. It's not even a Super Hornet anyway, it's the F7C. What, the F7C up the apples and pears? Sandy Gardner! Here we go. It's all kicking off already. Look, there's a great big hole in it. What's going on here? I can see right through my Hornet. I'm going to change servers, I think. That's what this little escapade has told me. If this works, I'll be a monkey's uncle. Okay. Right, off we go. Let's just get out of here. Star Citizen has stopped working. Oh, Lord above. Lord, can you hear me? Please, if you hear my prayer, I'm begging you now. I don't ask you for much, Lord, but dear baby Jesus, please deliver unto me a working buccaneer, that I might sally forth into the verse and shoot innocent people in the back of the head. Please, Lord, help me to do your bidding. And well, that was absolute rubbish. So I'm going to go on this one. I don't want to live in a world like this. It's simply unacceptable. Tell you what, I forgot my coffee. That's a bit annoying, isn't it? I might have to hop off and go and get it. 7:49. And we're already... absolutely nothing's happened. You wouldn't watch a film like this, would you? What happens... oh, it's a great movie. What happens in the first 8 minutes? Oh, he wakes up, he runs out, he presses some buttons, tries to get in a car, he can't get in. He tries to steal a car, but another guy gets in it before him, so he backs off. And then he runs around the corner, he orders up another car, comes out, he can't get in that one either. Actually, I wouldn't mind watching that film. It sounds quite good. It's quite edgy. Like, what, why can't he get in the car? What's going on there? Where does he need to get to? What's his mission? Why is he so frantic to get in a car? What's his frustration? Why does he keep going on about Bible bashes? Seriously, though, Olisar, it's like a Christian camp, isn't it? It's like you feel like it's... I don't know, it's sort of like... God Squad. Nothing, I've got nothing against God Squad. And a very fine squad they are too. And may their God reign in perpetuity. All eternity. For he doth createth the... he did scatter the potpourri amongst the pods, and the potpourri, and lo, the potpourri was scattereth, and below the big bennies did rain from the sky, like manna from heaven, and they did sup upon the big bennies, and they were and their bellies were full, and lo, they did procreate, and they became the tribe of the potpourri, and they left the pod, for it was a mangy pod, and they stepped forth in the knowledge they were in pod number 7. And they were! And lo, it came to pass that they were in pod number 7. Lo, the easy hab pod 7 was given unto them. And they did sally forth into the verse and do the Lord's work. But not before they visited the John and took a sup of his nectar, the mighty power-up, the Lord's drink of pips. And the other servants, lo, they did not believeth in him. And he did saluteth them, but they stood there like a lemon dressed as a frog, and did nothing. And so he, in his anger, smote them down, and he did harass them, and did grief them, until they, the Philistines, were sent back to the land of frogdom from whence they cameth. Yeah, that's right, I'm harassing you. I'm trolling you, mate! Anyway, I'm going to run away now, because I'm doing the Lord's work, alright? So leave me alone. Big Benny's anyone? No! Stay away from the ladies' toilets, you. They're not in the game. I hate it when people don't salute back at me. It really gets my goat! And I'm a religious man. It takes a lot to get me riled up. I tell you that. Here we go. Down we go. In we go. Round we go. Through we go. Yes, yes, yes. The Port Alisar ship deck. Yes, yes, yes. Right, let's just get in the F7C, 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 what the F7C? I just want to get out of this.
Your ship has been delivered to the firing landing pad.
I want to get out of this area where miracles do happen. BO7 is the sign from the Lord. Oh my God. Quick, let's get out of here before all the lucky number sevens add up and reverse and turn me into 666, Satan's own spawn. I'm going to get into my destiny. My destiny is Grimhex. Here we are. We're in, like Flynn. Oh, it's a frog boy again. What do you want, eh? Hey, what do you want, eh? What do you want, mate? What do you want? You sneaking up on me? You got something to say, have you? What is it? Pleb. Right. 07 it is. 07, come on. Let not the frog people of Olivar bother me no more. Up the apples and pears we go. Sandy Gardner! Eric Kyron Davis is with me. And we all know, service ain't over till all the snakes are back in the bag. Right, here we are. Oh, come on, man. You've got to be kidding me, haven't you? I'm praying. I'm praying. I'm pleading with you, Lord. I'm pleading. I'm on my knees, Lord. I'm pleading with you, Lord. I'm pleading with you. I'm on my knees here, baby. I'm on my knees, Lord. Oh, come on, then. Help me, praise Jesus. Come on, and help me. Glory. Glory. No, it's not happening. Well, that's it. I'm renouncing God. I renounce you. I renounce you. I will change. And he fell. And lo, his legs did not break. And he ran. He ran like the wind. Hey, I think we lost a disciple there. He's crossed over to the other side. He's gone to the other side. He left Strip B, where all is holy. He's gone over to the evil. The evil side of Strut A. A, as we all know, brethren, is the second letter of Satan. There are two A's in Satan. Is there a B in Satan? Let me hear you say Jesus. Glory. There's no A in Jesus. There is no A in God. But there are two A's in Satan. He's crossed over to the evil, the satanic strut that is across the water from us. Lord, help us. Lord, save us. Glory. Come on and help me praise Jesus. Come on and help me praise Chris Roberts. Come on and help me. Let me hear you say Sandy. Sandy. Let me hear you say Gardner. Gardner. Let me hear you say Eric Kyron Davis. That's what you have to do to amuse yourself in the verse. He's totally lost it. What's he talking about? What is he going on about? Eric Kyron Davis. It's got nothing to do with Satan. Have you seen his eyes? They're too close together. The man hasn't got enough features to cover his head. He's got all tiny little features all together in the middle of his great, giant, great head. He has to comb his hair across like that to cover up the dome on top. If that's not the work of the devil, don't know what it is. It's the work of some evil satanic hair gel. He gets shipped in from the land of Mordor. The land of Mordor. Oi, son. Can't you see I'm monologuing here? Do you mind? It's not to buzz me. I'm trying to get to pad 6. Or is it 9? As it turned out, he thought he was landing at pad 6. Right, now don't mess me about. There we go. Lovely little landing you did there. Let's see if it's any. We've got any luck spawning over here, shall we? I've got to get off this godforsaken dump. What I should have done is just gone on stream earlier without you knowing. Behind your back, so to speak. Have you been streaming behind my back?
Why didn't you tell me? Why didn't you just tell me? You were streaming with other streamers behind my back.
It's not that anyone cares. Right, okay. No one cares, John. That's the thing. Doors open, the halls glimmer, the posters shine in their digital glory. Dumpers depot, the cog turns, the head remains shaved, the hair will never, your hair will never grow back. Do you understand that? Do you understand that? Not only do you not exist, but your hair will never grow back. You're cursed with the haircuts Oh, everyone's in here then. This is where it's happening, is it? Is this where it all goes on, is it? Is this where it all happens? Oh, you people. You are unbelievable. All of you. Right then. All right. I get it. You're a big tough guy. Yeah, yeah. Pip's on the terminal. Bet that was you. It's the work of the devil, I tell you. Satan's glory. Come on and help me praise Satan. Right, come on then. Let's get in here. What do I want? What do I even want? I want this. I don't know what I want. I think I want that. 25 minutes? 2 minutes. That's the one. We've just got 2 minutes to kill. Alright? I'm going to be like Mace Windu after he's just inhaled some incense. I'm going to be so chilled out. I'm going to stand on the railing like an AI. Just taking it all in. Look, watch me now. We're going to go completely chilled. Yeah? Check this out. Look at the geezer. Look at him. He's calm. He doesn't care. Got a slight sneer on his face. What are you so uppity about, mate? What's your problem, eh? No one's taking any of this seriously, you know. We're not really Satanists. We're just trying to amuse ourselves while we wait for an Aurora. Aurora. Star Citizen. Aurora. All these words are so difficult to say. Maybe it's easier if you come from Wilmslow. Aurora. Aurora. I think we should call the ship Aurora. And we should call the game Star Citizen. Star Citizen. It's no more easy if you come from Wilmslow. I'm not saying that Chris comes from Wilmslow.
He comes all the way from Satan's a-hole.
No, that's not true either. Listen, do you want to come with me? Because I can help you. I know people who can help you with that problem. Nobody wears leather trousers anymore, mate. I hope you realise that. I don't want to push you into a corner, but... God, he's rooted to the spot, this geezer. Alright, well, I've got 7 frames. It's no better in here, is it, really? It's absolutely diabolical. If I could just get away from this ship. I mean, this station. Oh, Lord above. Can we get out of here? That's the question. That's got to be 2 minutes now, isn't it? It's got to be 2 minutes now, isn't it, mate? Come on! Spitting feathers here, what's going on? Awaiting delivery, 22 seconds. Oh. Let's just wait it out, shall we? Let's try to remain calm. Try to remain mindful of those around you. And try not to, like, get too excited. Because, you know, all excitement leads to emotion. And emotions, well... got to suppress them, keep them down. They're the devil's work. Right, here we go. He's in. Now, don't tell me. When has an Aurora ever let you down, eh?
Your ship has been delivered to the firing landing pad.
CO7. It's a sign. It's a sign from Jesus, the baby Jesus himself. He's blessed us with an Aurora. Thank you, Chris. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Erin. Thank you, Lord Chris. Cycling today, Ma. Now, I haven't been doing many of the missions recently. I've been sort of concentrating my own sort of monetary well-being. So I'm going to try to make a little bit more cash as we go through the verse this evening, if we ever get off this godforsaken Bible camp. Up the apples and pears. Eric Kyron Davis. We shall see the Aurora, the old bucket of bolts, as she is known. The old bucket of bolts, here she is. Look at this beautiful, beautiful article. I can hear the roaring of an engine. That's why they call it an Aurora. Because it auroras like a lion. I love this noise now. Little, like, ball bearings or something. Right, she's awake. Enjoy the ride.
Take off. Shields, legs. Landing gear, planes.
Well, that didn't go very well. I don't know what happened there, people. I was on full forward thrust for some reason. I don't know why. Game is just quite buggy at the moment, I guess. Not quite sure what the reason for that would be, other than somebody's gone off the boil. Anyway, here we are. We're in the game now, so let's just get out of here. Now, I did have a list, actually, before we do this. There was a little bit of something that I need to look at here. I'm going to go to Selin, and I'm going to go to Hicks Research. Not so much of a sell-in as a sell-out. Oh, come on. Cryastro, then. It's really buggy tonight. Don't know why. Don't know if anyone else is having that problem. Get the views going on. Never get a good view of the Aurora, I've noticed. It's always too zoomed in. There's nothing you can do about it. Like, it's just like when it's in quantum mode, it accelerates out of shot of the camera. I don't know if my cinematic camera's sort of not set up properly or what, but I do feel like maybe there's something in the settings I need to look at. If anybody's listening or watching, I need help. All right, I need help to sort out my settings. Right, let's get directly to sell-in. Not so much of a sell-in as a sell-out. And then we're going to go looking for you now. Now this is, if anyone who doesn't know this is the Aurora. This is the starting ship in the great, wonderful imagination of Chris Roberts, called Star Citizen. Oh, excuse me. It's been a long day. Took down a lot of scaffolding this morning. It's taken its toll on me. Where we are. Huh. A little bit jittery today, aren't we? It's really buggy today. I don't know why that is. Not quite sure. Hicks Research is down here, but we need to go to the OM here. Anyway, this is the Aurora. This is the starting ship that you get with your first game package. I don't know if I can show you it properly here. I can't seem to zoom out very well. Maybe if I do this. No, it doesn't seem to be doing it. All right, but anyway, that's what it looks like. It looks like a sort of, I don't know, like a metallic insect. It looked like something out of the sort of like, it looks like an 80s shopping center, basically, crossed with a sort of stick insect. If a stick insect had been designed in the 80s as a shopping center, that's your Aurora. Anyway, in the meantime, we're going to go to this. This is an OM, which stands for Oscillating Mollusk. And they are basically giant snails that live on the glass at the back of the game. Because obviously, the game isn't infinite. It's held inside a fish tank in Chris's bedroom. And the back of that, on the back of that glass, they have these giant snails. So they're mollusks, and they oscillate. They go up and down on the glass like that. And then if you align yourself with one of those oscillating mollusks, you can get closer to the edge of the game, which is in front of you always, because you're always looking at one of the four edges of the game. Stands to reason. It makes perfect sense when you think about it. I mean, do you know what I mean? I don't want to get too technical, but I mean, that's how it is. You can't avoid this kind of jargon. If you really want to know about Star Citizen, then I'll tell it like it is. You know what I mean? I'm not. Oh, no word of a lie, mate. It's all the old things in the fish tank, isn't it? It's like a fish tank, like one big fish tank, and we're all fish. We're all fighting for survival.
in the fish tank of Chris Roberts' imagination.
Seven, eight. Do I hear nine? 9 5, 9 8, 9 9. I got 9 over there, the gentleman in the blue hat. Oh yeah, all from the oscillating mollusk. We got 1,000, 1,400, 1,040, 1,080, 1,122. Sold! Sold to the gentleman in the orange pyjamas. Going once for 1,212. Going twice for 1,212. Do I hear 1,213? Do I hear 1,214? No, going! Sold to the gentleman at Hicks Research for 1,212. It's the Aurora, the pansy little ship that I have brought. Do you know what I've done? I've brought the wrong ship, haven't I? I can't do out in this little 80s shopping centre disguised as a stick insect. I can't do anything in this. It's ridiculous. Right, let's change our plan. Let's just... let's just see what we can see up here. Is there somewhere where you can spawn ships in this place? Where's Terra Mills? What do Terra Mills do? I'm going to go to Tram and Myers mining and see if I can spawn a ship there. Is that even possible? Does anyone know? Is there anyone in chat at the moment? As it goes. No, of course not. Of course no one's watching. Why would anyone watch this? Right, Tram and Myers mining. Okay, right, let's go there. Let's just go there. Six to eight, six to eight, seven to eight, seven, seven for the gentleman there. Drum and Myers mining, we got seven on the side, but the tower is 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 8 5 Just get so bored waiting around for things to happen. Right, let's just take a little nosedive. See if we can kill off some of that speed before it kills us. I don't know why I keep speeding up all the time. Doesn't make any sense to me, this. It's like the throttle's broken. It's really odd. It's like the throttle's literally broken. My cruise mode is bugged. I don't understand it. You come out of cruise mode and you literally can't get out of it. You move and it snaps you back into cruise mode again. And I've put on the space brake. I've dropped the throttle right back to zero, and I'm still dropping down 100 or so meters per second and then speeding up again. It might be the angle of my dangle, but I've got no altimeter, so it's very hard to see where I am. Anyway, it's all fun and games, isn't it? It's a right old laugh. Right, what I'm going to do, I'm going to drop myself down here and see if I can get another ship. And if I can't get another ship, I'm going to take a slight pause and I'll be back when I've got myself sorted out. Because it's been a hell of a day. I've had a terrible time. I've been to 4 weddings, 2 funerals and a bar mitzvah. And I'm done. Hello, I can see something coming on the horizon. Something's coming. And you know it's gonna be bad. Right, here we go. I hope somebody's there. I feel slightly piratical this evening. I have to say, I feel the blood rising. The black, dark, liquefied squid ink of the piratical nature rising from the spleen, filling the mind with dark thoughts, clouds of ignominy. Now listen, what I don't want at any point in my life is a great white orb appearing on my HUD. Just get lost, alright? I'm not interested. What is that thing even it's supposed to be anyway? How does it help you to have a giant, like, glowing melon in front of your face when you're trying to fly? Right, I'm not going to be able to spawn anything here, am I? Look at it. Place is a dump. Alright, well we'd give it a punt. Why not? I tell you what, I'm getting fed up with this. The acceleration on this thing is ridiculous this evening. I don't know if they've changed the flight model or something, but it's ridiculous. Like, it's so unresponsive. Like, you put a little touch on and you can't slow down. Look at this. Look at that. Oh well, whatever. Alright, let's just put it. Yeah, whatever. Yeah. I've landed the ship. Here we are, right? We're here. Mess me about. Right, parked, haven't we? Right, this is the car park, innit? What do you want from me, anyway? Don't give me a hard time. You said you wanted to go and get Rizzlers. Well, here we are! Get your bloody Rizzlers. Scares the life out of me, that. But do you see what I mean, though? Like a shopping centre in the 80s. You know those malls that they used to build with that were sort of like steel tubes and glass at funny angles, and there'd be like portholes in the toilet doors. Looks like one of those. Really odd. What people think is good design. These, however, I really like. Apart from the name of the game, the fact that nothing works, and the ship design, I think it's brilliant. But look at this, this is great. The design of this, fantastic. This is a really nice, functional, yet elegant looking caper. I'll tell you one thing I always wanted to know is it possible to go prone beneath these things and then, yes, go along like a little baby on my tummy. He's crawling underneath. Let's see if he can go that way. He's coming over that way, is he? Now look at this. Watch this now. Watch this. He's there. Look at him. Shooting holes in the ground like an idiot. not this one, but this one. So it is possible to sort of get down on your belly. Get forward a little bit here. And you could hold off from here. Why not? You know what I mean? You could be crouched here and bam. Psst. Not too shabby, is it? Hey, stand up, mind your head. Ow! What'd you do that for? Nearly knocked my own helmet off. Right, let's come on, let's get out of here now. Right, you're on your feet, son. On your feet. Put the guns down. Stop being a prat. Now, I'm going to pull that gun later on in this stream, and I'm not going to have enough bullets. And it's going to be my own fault. Because I didn't think ahead. I didn't plan the murder. I simply reacted. Every man is innocent until proven guilty. And I want you to remember that. I'm now presenting you with a lawsuit because the sound of the airlocks has been directly contravened from Mr. Dyson's own personal laboratory. Right, let's see if we can take some cargo. Don't even think cargo fits in these things. Oh look, we can put three of something in here. Let's see what we've got. Old Beryl's always good for a laugh, isn't she? Take some Beryl, come on, what the hell. So we paid 300, we paid three for that. Purchase Beryl, we'll do a little test. Why not, a little test. See how Beryl's getting on in the market. Yeah? And what we'll do, so we're gonna ignore all this art. I don't want to know about it, I'm not interested. We'll go to Grimace. Although, I did have a bit of paper here somewhere. How much is Beryl? Actually, that's not bad. I could go to Olisar. And get some beryllium. Poor old Beryl. She has a right old time of it. Lovely. Mr. Dyson is very pleased with the new sound. And the dust bucket. Sorry, not dust bucket. I meant rust bucket. I was thinking of the Aurora when I said that. So what is the armistice zone here then? There isn't one, basically. Which I'm really happy about that. Yeah, that's good. Let's get going. Let's get in the bucket of bolts and get out of here. So look, we bought three SCU of Beryl. And we'll just do a little sort of price test. Take it off to the place to be, and then we'll take this as I originally intended. My original intention was to go to Yellow and pick up the black cutlery, but I didn't remember to do that because I was too busy larking about. So now we've ended up with a stream gone wrong. It's an epic fail of a stream, it is.
Oh, they should put you on YouTube, mate. You're a right laugh.
It's a bit late for a system check, isn't it? How can I trust anything you say? You tell me the shields are raised and they're at max. You also tell me that the landing gear's raised and it isn't. How can I trust you, Chris? How do I get rid of that? You're going to behave yourself now, are you? There we go. Right. Ah. Now there's a fellow. Scoop 5. There he is, look. Coming in fast.
Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Got any missiles on this thing? Right, we're not going to cause you any grief. We're just going to leg it. You'll never catch me, son. Yes, madam. That's funny stuff. Right, he's 14, 15. He's happy. He's all right. He's all right. We go, we're at 1212, sold to the gentleman in the Miss Freelancer. He's 19, he's 20 kilometers gone, he's not bothered. We took a bit of a beating there, but that was a bit of fun. That's all right, I've still got my cargo, I'm still all right. Hey there, are you from the US or UK? You kidding me, mate, are you? Zithix, thank you very much for asking. I appreciate you stopping by just to ask that question. You may not still be there, but you may be there, I don't know. But in answer to your question, I am firmly and categorically from the UK. Where are you from? Are you from the US? I'm assuming you are. I'm only assuming that. It might not be true. Are you from the US? Zithix, are you from the US? Or are you from the UK? Answer me that and stay fashionable, son. Oh, that was a bit of fun, that was. I haven't done any dogfighting at all since 3.0 came out, because it's been too buggy. So that was the first time I've even been able to draw a bead on somebody. So it's all well and good. Zithix, answer me, man. Are you there? He's not there, he's gone. Right, so we're at selling now. Let's get ourselves... Actually, no, what the hell? Let's go back up to Cryastro. So we might need to partake of some repairs. We'll have a little look at the ship in a second. See how she's looking. All right. That's all good. So Scoop is not in the chat. Let me just send him a message. Quantum drive is now off. Hey, Scoops. Are you okay? Sorry, I could... could not resist. Jump in the map. Straight for Olisar. Off we go. Boom, boom. Where is she? Where's my little widget, eh? Where's my widget? There she is. I'm going to get shot at now as soon as I arrive, aren't I? Because I've got another crime stat. Unless he was a bad lad as well. So that's... my missile targeting's not working, by the way. So I'm a bit upset about. I probably would have stuck that out if I'd had my missiles have been working and targetable. I probably would have stuck that out.
Quantum drive is now off.
Okay, I believe you. Something up with this. There's something up with the thrust now. I don't understand it. Is it the thrust button itself? I'm not slowing down. Why is that? I've lost control of my ship now. Kind of annoying that, because I've... the thruster's not working. Don't usually have to go into PRE mode just to slow down. But what the hey. Anyway, I was glad to bring a little bit of fun into Scoops' life. See if he's answered me. He's not answering me, whatever. Right, let's just hail these bozos and see what the story is.
Please proceed to assigned landing bay.
Please assign me one then. Now they don't always assign you a landing bay if you come in too far away. No, they've got one. There we go. That's it. Okay, good. Nicely done. If I do say so, Missen. Hey there, are you from the US or the UK? Or? Alright mate, are you from the US or the UK? Zithix, why don't you answer me, man?
Landing complete. Have a pleasant stay.
I appreciate you stopping by the stream. Thank you for your attention. I merely wish to converse with you. I hope you're having a good evening or a good day, wherever you're from. I'm just arriving at Olisar because I'm going to try and sell a pittance of Beryl. Three tiny little crates of Beryl are being sold today. It's 11:30 here. Let's just get ourselves out here and get back into the business at hand, which is merely to do a very small amount of Beryl trading. Now if I go back to Tram and Myers
and I get some more Beryl, which I might do in a little while. I've got to see what the rest of the gang are up to first before I do said trading. If there's nought going on in here, I shall come back on stream, and if there is something happening in the house, I shall probably do that instead. We'll see, eh? Let's go and see what we can achieve. No. Right, we are going to sell. Aha! We're selling this. Beryl's at 11, so what's that? Okay. So I think I made 8 credits per unit on that. Satan's trousers, mate. There we go. So double my money, so that's alright, isn't it? I'm gonna take a bigger ship back and repeat that then. Because that's not bad. That's not bad at all. Anyway, I'm gonna do that in a minute. First of all, I would like to say thank you for watching, anybody who did watch. It's much appreciated. And I'll stand in front of this man with a stupid haircut. But out of respect, I salute the Mohican. There's nothing wrong with it in this day and age. 5 centuries later, people are still wearing it, and that's cool. All right, thank you very much for watching, especially you, Zithix. Thanks for dropping by, appreciate it, mate. And I'm from the UK, in case you're wondering. I bid you good night. I'll probably be back on in about 10 minutes. So see you then, bye.